am Shakib Thakur Rahman. I am a student of George Brown College. My major is Computer Programming Analyst. Professor Reza is our teaching instructor of Applied Data Science. And this is assignment 4, Working with Pandas. In this assignment, we need to follow the following steps using the Jupyter Notebook or any other environment to implement steps. I have imported the Pandas library SPD. I have imported the test CSV file into Python environment. And I have shown the first 5 rows of the data frame by using head method. And in this number 3, I drop the model column by using pandas drop method. Number 4, I have dropped the model column permanently using column assignment method. I have dropped the column 153 rows permanently by using drop method. And calculated the mean of range column. In number 7, number of F do we have in the type column by using len method and replace them permanently with AAA using lambda for each type column element and show the first 5 rows by using head method. In number 8, I have read of the comma, dollar sign, and from the cost column permanently by using string index and display the first 5 rows by using head method. Type of cost column have been shown by using dtypes method. Number 9, I have changed the cost column data type to integer by using stype integer method. I have calculated the average of cost column, then calculate the average of cost for each continent by using mean method. In number 11, I calculated the minimum, maximum, and standard deviation of the cost column group by each continent by using AZZ method. And I have calculated the minimum, maximum, and standard deviation of all numerical columns grouped by each continent by using AZZ method. In number 13, I have illustrated the mean of all numerical columns grouped by the continent using a bar chart by using df dot pilot kind is equal to bar method. And here I have count the number of each continent in the continent column by using value underscore counts method. In number 15, I have shown the percentage of each continent in the continent column by using value underscore counts normalize is equal to true into 100 method. And I have shown the unique values that we have in the continent column by using unique method. Then show the number of unique values that we have in the continent columns by using the len method. I have used the value underscore count method for the cost column. And in number 18, I have followed a histogram for the cost column by using plot.hist method. I have changed the number of beans to 50 to show the result more accurately. In number 20, I have provided a brief summary of null value for the entire data frame by using isNA.sum method. Here I have shown how many rows will remain in my DF after drop all non rows by using len method. In number 22, I have shown the statistics for type column using the value underscore count method. In question number 23, I have replaced the type column missing value with XXX by using replace method. I have dropped the rows that have any missing value permanently by using drop na method and show the number of rows by using len method. Also, I have set the ID columns as the new index by using set underscore index method and show the first 5 rows of the DF by using head method and show the value of the cell that its ID is 70 and its column header is value by using lock method. In number 26, I have shown the index column and the shape of the current DF. Bring back the ID column to the DF and reset the index. Again, show the index columns and the shape of the current DF. In number 27, I use the describe method to see the statistics of my DF and fetch the value of the first row and the third column of the result. Here, I sort the value underscore counts of the continent column of the DF by using sort values method, then sort the value columns of the continent column based on the alphabetic order of the continents by using sort underscore index method. In number 29, show all the columns of the following rows 1, 3, 5, 7 using ILOC method and show the first 7 rows of the following columns type and continent also using ILOC method. In the last one, number 30, show the value of the type that are equal to XXX by using lambda method. Thank you for listening to me. I hope you really enjoyed my video.